So what's it like for NanoMech to win an Edison Award?
Well, it's exciting because, you know, who it's named after. I mean, Thomas Edison. And everything he invented also, you know, was a solution to something. I mean, it actually was useful.
So how do you use those tools today to be able to drive through lots of obstacles that are in the way of innovation?
You know, with the invention of the chip and software and storage and now the internet, the ability to communicate instantly anywhere, you know, it's changed everything, but it's an accelerator of invention to the extent that you can move faster and you can collaborate incredibly to create innovations at a speed that never existed before. So that means, at the end of the day, that more will probably be invented in the next 5-10 years than in the history of mankind.
So when you look at older companies, you think about R&D, but here I am looking at your company, you have over 100 scientists. Why over 100 scientists?
Because a lot of people think innovation is improvement. I believe it, you've got to obsolete it. So when we come up with a product at NanoMech, we have to obsolete literally everything else that's out there. It's not a 5% improvement, it's not a 20% improvement. Typically, it's got to be at least 100%, a 2x, upwards to a 10x, to really get the attention, get the momentum, get the capital behind it in order to launch that innovation, that breakthrough.
So Jim, I look at your pedigree and it's very, very impressive.
Thank you.
Why NanoMech now, as opposed to some other company?
And I met some fantastic nanoscientists that were working on totally reinventing oil. I mean, that's a big market, mm-hmm. And lubricants. And at the end of the day, the world runs on machines, and machines run on lubricants and coatings. And so, you know, motor car that we deal with, or we're winning the Indy 500 along with major teams, which we do. Underneath all of that is nanotechnology that makes that go.
So what's the next big innovative thing that you think is going to come from nano?
All the problems left in manufacturing are at nanoscale, all of them. And so that means all the solutions are at nanoscale. Nanoscience, nanoscale invention will do so many things, not only in the material science where we are every day, improving anything to do with material science, manufacturing, and resurging manufacturing, but especially in medicine.
So Jim, thanks for joining us and talking about the Edison Awards today.
Just to be a part of this for, you know, somebody involved in innovation is a real privilege.